Whoa, you're recording now?
Yeah.
Right, let's talk about the principles of editing, shall we? And first, we're going to talk about the historical development.
Motion pictures were first projected on large screens in the United States in 1896. In the same year, Edwin S. Porter entered the industry. After a few years' experience, he took charge of the productions at the great inventor Thomas Edison Studios. Over the next decade, his work would have tremendous influence in filmmaking. In his earliest films, instead of using cuts between shots, Porter would go from one image to another, using gradual transitions, a technique that became known as a dissolve. It helped the viewers follow complex movement. In 1903's The Great Train Robbery, Porter gave audiences an entirely new visual experience. The one-reel film, only 12 minutes long, was put together in 20 different shots. It was groundbreaking in its use of cross-cutting editing to show separate action from different places. Between 1903 and 1905, he demonstrated the techniques that would become the basic strategies of visual communication between the film and the viewer. He helped develop the modern concept of continuity editing and paved the way for another pioneer, D.W. Griffith.
And now we're moving on to the 180 degree rule and the 30 degree rule, and I'll show you how it's done. There's the 180 degree line. And there will be character A, character B. Your 180 degree rule, the line, will be here. I don't know how to explain it.
Do what you did before.
180 degree rule, it's very simple. Say this is the camera, you can put it there, pop one there, and you're fine. But then, there's the other bit. If you put the camera there, that's very naughty. Basically, you're not allowed to put the camera anywhere above the 180 degree line. The line's there. Clearly, it's there. You put it there, anywhere, there. And now, onto the 30 degree rule. Let's draw me line back. Hey. 30 degree there. Get it? 30 degree there. When you place your camera, make sure it's not there. Put it there, or here, anywhere here, but not there. It's got to be at least 30 degree there. There's a gap there. There. And I think that's self-explanatory, really.
Corrected one of these days.
Your Mr. Bernstein sent Junior the most incredible atrocity yesterday, Charles. I simply can't have it in the nursery.
Mr. Bernstein is apt to pay a visit to the nursery now and then.
Does he have to?
Yes.
Really, Charles?
I'm just going to explain to you the rule of thirds. Ready? Basically, a whole frame, this bit, you divide it into thirds, and the character's eyes has got to match the first line, like so. Yeah? What?
It should be a little downwards because it's not
right there.
That way, yeah.
Yes, now his eyes are now match on the top line. It's got, when you frame the character, the eyes has got to be in line with the top half, top third of your thirds. So your character, you can't frame him there or there, he's out of the shot there. He's got to be in line with the thing, with the line. I'm on fire,
this is why I'm hot. This is why I'm hot. This is why. This is why. This is why I'm hot. This is why I'm hot. This is why I'm hot. This is why. This is why. This is why I'm hot. I'm hot cause I'm fly. You ain't cause you not. This is why. This is why. This is why I'm hot. I'm hot cause I'm fly. You ain't cause you not. This is why. This is why. This is why I'm hot. This is why I'm hot. I don't gotta rap. I could sell a mill saying nothing on the track. I represent New York, I got it on my back. Niggas say that we lost it, so I'ma bring it back. I love the